how you going? It's Saturday afternoon, about 4:30. Got out of hospital last night. The options that they gave me, because my creatinine is over 1,000, they wanted to, my renal team wanted to try to speed up the PD, the peritoneal dialysis, to put the catheter in. And so that's why they got me out of hospital so quickly. But the Surgeon General, because I'm not showing any symptoms, I'm not showing any, I'm still, for all intents and purposes, fine. The general surgeon didn't agree to fast track my peritoneal dialysis. And so the next best option that they gave me was for me to get a tunnel line or a center line, which will be an entry point at the top of my heart. So there'll be two tubes coming out so that they can, if they need to do quick hemodialysis, they can, and it's available. So I get that done on Wednesday. And then they got me an appointment to see the surgeon on the Friday up there in Canberra. So what my renal specialist said to me was, I can either stay in hospital over the weekend until Wednesday or go home and then come back Wednesday morning. So I chose to come home, which is fantastic because I got to watch the girls' first netball game today. Come home and have a nice cup of vanilla and chamomile tea. I'll be able to put together the scripture readings for church tomorrow and just relax at home with the family. So Olivia drove me to Braidwood last night, and then Joe picked me up, and then we came down. This thing's messing with my head, man. It really is. Dialysis, kidney failure. It's messing with my head because my diabetes is gone. Like, through lifestyle change and exercise, all my blood sugars is fine, but my kidneys, for whatever reason, complication, have just declined. Interesting that the doctor said to me when I presented a couple of weeks ago with the cramps, he said to me, "You don't like doctors, do you?" And it's true. At that point, I didn't. I thought being sick was a sign of, probably still do, but being sick is a sign of weakness, and you just suck that up. In life, you just suck it up and you just keep going. You don't, feel a little bit sick, don't worry about it. It'll come right. And that's what I felt with my diabetes, and that's what I felt with, my condition. My eyes, got better. Like I said, my blood sugar levels, glucose levels are fine. It's just these kidneys, and part of what's I'm here is just that attitude of, if I don't, if I can just sort of figure it out and fix it myself and just keep pushing on through, it'll be okay. Well, it was in some things, but definitely not in this. And so I've I'm eating all the right stuff for kidney, like cauliflower soup and off the coffee, and just trying to get my phosphorus levels and we had a blood test on Monday, and see the GP, so really tight monitoring now, but can only do what I can do. I vacillate between, dialysis is going to be good, and then I get to the point where this is, it's going to be a total life change. So I've got a lot of people praying for me. Every time I speak to my father-in-law, Jeremy prays for me, and I really do sense strength and life from his words. I've got all the people in my church and all the people around praying for me. I spoke to my elder sister today on the phone. I haven't told any of that side of my family yet. I think I'll hopefully tell them maybe next week. I know this is going up online, but this is documenting the journey. I haven't told anybody, but my sister, Pia, said she's been thinking about me for the last couple of weeks, and I almost felt like telling her. But my other sister, my second elder sister, she's going through her battles with cancer, and I just want to get my deal sort of squared away. I don't want to worry them too much, and I know if they would find out, they'd come rushing down and they'd be ringing the doctors and finding all that. So Joe and I, well, me personally, just want to get that all my stuff settled and then let them know. But it's so funny. Yesterday too, at the about to leave, I had to get a blood form, and it's like rush to get up there, then nothing. Like rush to get up to the hospital, expecting to get surgery, then no surgery. And then, okay, you can go, but then you have to go back and get something else. So stop, start. So I'll be interested to see just how this thing unfolds. I'm trying to stay really present in the moment. Like I really enjoyed the sun today, I really enjoyed being with my family today, and not trying to think too much ahead. My spiritual director, Sister Carmel, said to trust God in every moment, and that's what I'm trying to do. Just stay grounded and present in each moment, and figure it out. Just step by step. Don't overthink it. So, yeah, happy to be home. Happy to have a cup of tea. Red scarf. Red shoes. So, life's good. Thanks for watching.